to break the nucleus in the anterior chamber, we need a cannula which is very good, about 26 gauge. It should be strong and should not bend on pressure. So that's the cannula I use. Even when you press something hard, it doesn't press. The commercially available cannulas are not as strong. These are regular 26 gauge needles, which are available in plenty, and we use the same needle for doing rexes too. So we need a kumi or similar combination stone of silicon carbide. This says it's got a serial number of 108. And this needs to be processed. I think it has to be kept in motor oil for overnight. Then it has to be cleaned and it's ready for use. My assistant will show you, demonstrate as to how to prepare a cannula from a needle. So that's the needle. Yeah, and he takes the needle and rubs it on the stone the way he's doing it. And it's a very quick procedure. And you will be turning the needle continuously in all directions till the entire bevel goes up, goes away. And he need to test the, then he is holding it. This is a better way to hold it on a syringe like a pen and doing it. The combination stone has got a rough surface on one side and has got a smooth surface on the other side. You can actually start on the rough surface and then the finishing stage you can go to the smoother side. And we need to check whether the there's no bend at the end. There's fluid in the syringe and you just flush it and see that the full thickness, full amount of water comes out, and he'll give a demonstration on the. If there is any block, you can redo it and see that the full stream comes axial to the coaxial to the needle. There are. It's not a perfect one. Is it all right? You'll have to redo it. Redo it a little more. And see that there are no sharp edges. Initially, I'll give a demo. Initially, make it perpendicular, then turn it to about 30 degrees, 45 degrees, and rotate the needle continuously so that there are no shaft ends remaining, shaft edges remaining at the tip of the cannula. So this cannula can be bent at about 30, 35 degrees or 45 degrees, up to that, depending upon the depth of the entry chamber, and you can use it any number of times. These are requested many companies to make them commercially. Some of them have made it. One of them made by JMS is really good. It's got the cutting needle that they use for the skin incorporated into the cannula, and the way it cuts hard nuclei much better than the cannulas we make. These cannulas are good, and basically you're going to keep the nucleus and continuously inject viscoelastic and support the back. The posterior part of the nucleus is supported by the wire vectors, and you go in the front, and as you see in the video, you guillotine it. You go vertically down and it bisects. You don't have to do any saw motion. You vertically go down, it bisects it. Do not try hard nuclei initially. That cannula is ready now for use. It can be autoclaved. Do not try a hard nuclei. Try with smaller, softer nuclei and then progress to harder and harder nuclei. See that you are watching the wire vectors and the cannula continuously, and in case you go to a side, the nucleus can tumble and it may have a somersault in the anterior chamber, which is not good for endothelium. So the essence is bisecting the nucleus to make it smaller using a 26 gauge cannula, that's homemade cannula. The next is continuously injecting viscoelastic in front of the nucleus as you are bisecting the nucleus. And third is slightly move the nuclear hemi pieces to one side, not to the extreme angle region, and see that viscoexpression of the hemi nucleus happens. Thank you.